Alright guys, here's another Project Cal video coming at you. I'm going to be showing you Zelda. So, let's talk about Zelda and her design in Vanilla Melee. So, in Vanilla, Zelda is like, she's in the second bottom tier. She's down there with the Game & Watch, Roy, Mewtwo. So she's pretty bad. You know, the only character she really has a slight advantage on are Bowser and Kirby, which are the two lowest tier characters. So, yeah, she doesn't have a whole lot going for her in Vanilla Melee. Now let's talk about her design. So in Vanilla, she's a slower character, you know, floaty. And so I feel like one of the weird things they did to kind of give Zelda strength is they just made her, some of her moves just weird. Like in Vanilla, her forward air and back air both do 20 damage. And she has two of the same move, so it doesn't stale as easily. And so like 20 damage, that's 2% more than Captain Falcon's knee, which is already crazy strong. Imagine if Captain Falcon had a forward and a backwards knee. That was as fast as Zelda's. Like, Falcon has 12 frame startup. I believe Zelda has like 8 frames. It's fast, and it's super strong. So, that doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me. That is too strong for the character to have. And yeah, that's one of the really strong things about Zelda and Vanilla Melee is they just made that just like weirdly super powerful, even though everything else is so bad. So that's kind of where we're coming from with Zelda. But so to change, let's talk about the few things I nerfed for Zelda, because there's just a couple. Let's cover those first. A few things I nerfed were, so her forward air and back air. So they no longer do 20 damage, they do 17. So they're still fast, they're still strong, but two hits isn't giving you 40 damage, it's giving you like 30, or if you use the same move twice, like 32. So that's quite different. I mean, every little bit of damage is significant, so that's not as crazy, which I feel like is how it should be. So yeah, her forward air and back air slightly nerfed. I also changed her down smash. In Vanilla it does 13 damage, and this does 11. And the angle and knockback are, the angle is slightly higher, the knockback is slightly less. A high percent down smash just can kill on its own. I feel like you should have a chance to come back after getting hit with down smash. The purpose of the move is to set up an edge guard, not to kill at higher percents. So I changed that. Other than that, I think that's everything. Yeah, I think that's all the nerfs. So let's go on to what we've buffed. Let's start with her normals. So, her jab, it actually has some shield damage on it now. It does, each hit has 1% shield damage, which is not a lot, but if you space it out, it's, you know, it's pretty good on shield. It'll poke sometimes, which is nice. High percent, it also has a little bit more knockback, so at high percent, you can try and convert something off of it. So, jab actually has some utility now, slightly better. Two things I didn't change that were already pretty good in Melee were her forward tilt and up tilt. In fact, I think I might have nerfed them a little bit. The knockback was too high because they could kill on their own too easily. But yeah, great. They're great at putting you in a bad position. They have good hitboxes. Up tilt lasts for a long time, so they are just really good moves, very very solid moves that could get something started for you. And as you can see, they still kill fairly early. Fox's fastfaller, so that's pretty good. But those are not buffed from vanilla. Those are actually slightly nerfed, I believe. So yeah, tilts are the same pretty much. Her aerials, let's go into her aerials now. Her aerials are all pretty much different. I don't think there is one that I left unchanged. For example, so we all know about forward air, back air. Fire! Her down air, Zelda's down air in vanilla Melee, it's pitiful to say the least. It does 8 damage in vanilla, and it has almost no knockback. So, yeah, that can't stand. What I've done is I've added some damage, so it does 11. So it's still weak. It's weaker than the vast majority of aerials. But now it actually has some damage to it, and it has an electric effect. So the electric effect just keeps you in stun longer. So that helps, because felt like the knockback didn't need to be crazy. As you can see, Fox didn't get knocked down to like 90 damage. But the electricity helps the move work as an edge guarding tool, where it normally wouldn't without the electricity. So that's why I added that. You can still meteor cancel it. Still not very powerful, but it can actually put in some work now. Where you're in vanilla, it was just better to never ever use that. So that's different. Zelda's up air is probably the least changed. I just added some damage. It does 15 instead of 13 damage now. So that's good. And Zelda's nair. So her neutral air in vanilla is bad. To reiterate, some of Zelda's weaknesses is she's slow, and some of her moves just do not work at all in vanilla. She has some moves just don't work, and she also has like no kill confirms, no setups into anything. For example, for moves that don't work, her forward smash, you could DI out of her forward smash with, like, without even trying in vanilla. Her neutral air was like this in vanilla, just very weak. So I feel like that needed to be changed. Still too weak. I don't know, that move's not as good as scooping him up as it is catching him in the air. Fire! Which I think I'm fine with, actually. But her forward smash, DI out of it easy. Neutral air, DI out of it easy. Up smash, DI out of it easy. Like, those moves didn't work. Not anymore. So, Zelda's neutral air connects better. Last hit has electricity. Sticking with the whole Zelda's magic thing. And it actually is a usable move now. It's decent. It's not super great, but it does what it's supposed to, and it does it pretty well. So that's different. Little fun fact, you probably may have noticed that in vanilla Melee, Zelda's neutral air has no sound effect besides the like the whoosh sound. So I added the little tinkling sound effect because it has the sparkles. Why shouldn't it have the tinkling sound? So I added that in. Felt like that was a much needed improvement. So that covers all her normals. Kind of covered her smashes. Forward smash. The trade-off is it does connect better, but the damage and the knockback isn't as crazy, but it still is extremely good at setting up an edge guard, which I feel like is powerful in and of itself. So If you hit with this move, they're gonna go off stage unless they have some crazy DI. They have good DI to get out of it. As you can see, up smash actually can do what it's supposed to now. Still has that part in the middle where you can slip out of it. So, yeah, if you know what you're doing, you can still get out of it. But if Zelda catches you trying to fall, you're gonna get scooped up. So it doesn't do everything, but if you get caught in the air, you get scooped up, you're in the air, Zelda gets to have fun with that. So that cover smashes. So another thing. Let's go on to her specials now. Another thing I forgot to mention. So the other moves that have trouble working, like forward smash, up smash, neutral air, was neutral B. In vanilla, you could D out of this move pretty easily. Spit you out without you really having to try. That's not true. It basically has set knockback, and it's a little bit harder to DI out of. But if you get hit with it, you get set knockback, and at higher percent, you'll get knocked down. So like, as you can see, Fox getting knocked down at 60%. So that's kind of nice. There's another get off me move, like down smash, which just has different timing, different uses than down smash. Keeps him on the stage so you can try and follow up. So I guess at a high percent you'd rather do that unless you try to get an edge guard. Yeah. So it works differently now, but I feel like that's an improvement. Next up we have Din's Fire. So Din's Fire, move that did not work in Vanilla Melee. How it was designed is it started up slow and ended fast, which makes no sense, because at the end of the projectile you want to be able to aim. But in Vanilla it's super hard to aim. You have very little control. But in this, you have more control. Starts out fast and slow, so you have an easier time aiming it. You can control where it goes slightly better. And another thing is it has a hitbox like Ness's up B. It knocks you in the direction you're hit by the projectile, which actually gives Zelda a setup into like a forward air or back air, which she definitely never had before. So it works at higher percent, and projectile is still hard to aim with. Probably most likely gonna use it when they're off stage, but yeah, you can get something off of it now, which is nice. So that's different, and the last special that is very much different is up B. So another fun fact, in Vanilla Melee, there is actually a hitbox on the end of Zelda's up B, where she poofs back into view. But there's a hitbox saved in the code in the game. But the way that it's programmed, it doesn't execute the hitbox. It doesn't execute it correctly. So even though there's a hitbox that's supposed to be there, the game doesn't execute it because the way it's programmed is wrong. So I made it so programmed right. Boom. So yeah, now it has a hitbox on the end of it, and it's pretty strong. I modeled it, it's pretty much identical to Falco's up B. So I feel like if Falco gets a up B kill, why can't Zelda? And hers is actually arguably harder to land. I mean, if you get hit with it at high percent randomly, like at a recovery, it sucks. But you're not going to die off of it. So, just one of the things you'll have to learn. I don't feel like it's too powerful to get hit randomly like a neutral with it. But yeah, it gives Zelda a kill confirm. Now she can do stuff to get that kill. It's still difficult to land, for sure. But if you can play your cards right, you might get it. So she's got the starting hit of up B, which can lead to it up throw. She's got up tilt, forward tilt. And I think even the move itself, if you get hit with it once, it can lead into itself, which is kind of gnarly. But like I said, it's difficult to land. But I feel like that's a pretty interesting skill required kill, which will be fun to try to use. Pretty much exactly like Zelda in Smash 4. So, yeah, hope that's a fun little change. Yeah, see, Fox at 160%. He's not dying off the top. Granted, he is a fast player, but, still, just don't get hit. You can shield it, you can just avoid it. It's hard to land, hard to aim. So yeah, it's not too bad. Last thing, so Sheik's Grab. So one of the things in Vanilla Melee that made Sheik so bad was her grab was terribly slow. For comparison, most grabs, like Fox, Falco, Sheik, Marth, Falcon, Mario, Luigi, Peach, all those guys have a grab that comes out in frame 7. There's the tether grabs that are slower, and I think DK and Bowser's grabs are slower. They come out on frame 9, so 2 frames, not that much of a deal, but it is slower. But Zelda's grab in Vanilla is frame 12, which is awful. It's so bad. So I've changed the grab to match Bowser's. It comes out in frame 9. So it deserves to be slow, because Zelda's grabs are strong. She can get something started, but so it is slower, but yeah. It's 3 frames faster. Not terrible like it was in Vanilla. So that's a nice change. That is a significant improvement. Yeah, so that's pretty much Zelda. Those are all her moves. I feel like she's still she's a much stronger mid-tier character now. I don't think she's super strong, just because she still has a hard time setting up kills, and I don't know. She has a much harder time setting. She has a not a much harder. She has a hard time setting up kills. And she's still pretty slow, but she has great airspeed, just like Vanilla, so she has that going for her. But, yeah, we'll see how she turns out. I need people to playtest it to see how it meshes with everything else, but, yeah, I hope you like it. Thanks for watching.